today, I offer to Christ my God and my King, teach him to forgive my sins from sons of our father David the prophet. May his blessings be with us all. Of the sixth hour of this blessed day, I offer to Christ my God and my King, beseeching him to forgive my sins from sons of our father, David the prophet, in his blessing be with us all. Holy, 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 the Holy Gospel according to St. John, may his blessings be with us all. Amen.
Standing in heaven, so because you are the gate of heaven, open for us the gate of mercy.
Oh God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, gospel, which has mercy on us.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, crucified for us and mercy upon us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, rose from the dead and sent heavens and mercy upon us. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and now forever and to the age of ages. Amen. Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, forgive us our sins. O Lord, forgive us our iniquities. O Lord, forgive us our trespasses. O Lord, who is the Savior of your people, heal them for the sake of your holy name. Our Father, and brethren, all fall asleep. O Lord, repose your souls. We are without sin, Lord, have mercy on us. We are without sin, Lord, help us and receive our supplications. Yours the glory in the name of trouble, holiness. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy on us.
O Lord, make us worthy to pray thankfully, our Father, who art in heaven. Hail to you, ask you, sin full of glory.
Hail, the Virgin Theotokos, the Mother of Christ. Lift up our prayers unto your beloved Son, that he may forgive us our sins. Hail to the Holy Virgin, our law, forth unto us, the true life, Christ our God. Ask the Lord on our behalf, that he may mercy on our souls and forgive us our sins. O Virgin Mary, the Holy Theotokos, the faithful advocate for all mankind, intercede on our behalf for our Christ, be more than we grant us the forgiveness of our sins. Hail to you, O Virgin, the righteous Queen. Hail to the bride of our race, who bore us, Emmanuel. We ask you to remember us, our faithful advocate, before our Lord Jesus Christ, and forgive us our sins.
Thuxas, Theos, Yomon, holy, 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 the holy gospel according to Saint Matthew, may his blessings be with us all. Amen.
Blessing the multitude who are under the last moment. Jesus, the disciples came to him and he opened them up and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger, good for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you who never know you in persecution, say all kinds of evil against you. Falsely for my sake, rejoice and be exceedingly glad. For great is your reward in heaven, for so they persecuted the prophets are before you. You are the salt of the earth, but of the salt of the flavor, how shall we season it? Good for nothing but to be gone, not to the foot by man. You are the light of the world, the city that sit on the hill cannot be hidden, nor does the light of the put on their basket on a man's and gives light to all in the house. Lay your light shine before men, and they may see your good works where our fathers in heaven.
Glory be to God forever. Amen. In the saint of God be fulfilled in peace. Worship the Christ, our God, to the good Father, and the Holy Spirit, for you have risen and saved us, have mercy upon us. All you know, on the sixth day and in the sixth hour was near to the cross. For the sin which our father Adam did commit in paradise, tear the handwriting of our sins, Christ our God, and save us. I cried to God, and the Lord heard me. God, hear my prayer, and do not refuse my petition. Be attentive to me, and hear me in the evening, in the morning, and at midday. I say my words, and hears my voice, and delivers my soul in peace. O Jesus Christ, our God, who was nailed to the cross at the sixth hour and came to sin by the tree, and by your death you made alive the dead man whom you created with your own hands and how died sin. Put to death our pains by your healing and love-giving patience, and by the merits with which your name rescue our minds from thoughtlessness of the earthly deeds and worldly lusts, to the remembrance of every commandment according to your compassion. Since we have no favor, no excuse, no justification, because of our many sins, we throw you implore to him who was born of you, through to the Virgin, for abundant and acceptable is your intercession with our Savior. O Holy Mother, do not exclude sinners from intercession with him whom you bore, for he is merciful and able to save us, because he suffers for us to deliver us. Let your compassion speed the reach us for exceeding humble. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the glory of your name. O Lord, deliver us and forgive us our sins, for the sake of your holy
cross to deliver those who are created from the mother's enemy. We cry out unto you and give thanks to you, for you have filled all with joy, O Savior, when you came to help the world. Lord, glory be to you. You are she who is full of grace, O Theotokos, the Virgin, we praise you through the cross of your Son. It is fell down, and this was abolished. We were dead, but we are raised and became ones of eternal life, and in that life is the first paradise. Therefore, we thank you, glorify the Lord of Christ, our God.
We exalt you, the Mother of the true life, and we glorify your sanctity, the first of you have brought forth unto us to save the whole world. You came and saved our souls. Glory be to our Master, our King, the Christ, the pride of the apostles, the crown of the martyrs, the joy of the righteous, the prince of the churches, and the forgiveness of sins. We proclaim the Holy Trinity of one Godhead, and we worship him and glorify him. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, bless us. Amen. We believe in one God, God the Father, the one supreme Lord, creator of heaven and earth, and all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father, before all ages, light of light, true God, true God, begotten, not created, the one essence of the Father, by whom all things are made, who for us man, for our salvation, came down from heaven, was incarnated of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man. And he was crucified for us in the Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried. On the third day, he rose from the dead, according to the Scriptures, ascended to the heavens. He sits at the right hand of his Father, descending in his glory to judge the living and dead. Yes, believing the Holy Spirit, the Lord, to give her life, proceeds from the Father, who is the Father and the Son, who worshiped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets, and one holy Catholic, the solid church. We confess our baptism for the remission of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Rescue them, O God, the meek, who takes away the sins of the whole world, to hear us, have mercy on us, and forgive us our sins. Amen.
Give us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us.
dedication to the one only holy Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church of God. Amen. Remember, O Lord, those who have brought to you these gifts, those on whose behalf they have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought, give them all the heavenly reward.
Pray for this holy and precious gift, and our sacrifice in those who bring them, Lord, have
mercy. Alleluia.
and accept the supplications and prayers of his saints, for that which is good on our behalf at all times, and to keep the life and standing of our honored Father and the High Priest, Pope Avatoadros, and his partner in the Apostolic Liturgy, our Father, the Bishop Abba Youssef, and to make us worthy to partake of the Holy Communion of his holy and blessed mysteries for the remission.
Hey. To all, that I might win the more.
And to the Jews I became as a Jew, that I might win Jews. To those who are under the law, as under the law, that I might win those who are under the law. To those who are without law, as without law, not being without law toward God, but under the law toward Christ, that I might win those who are without law. To the weak I became as weak, that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all men, that I might be all, I might by all means save some. Now this I do for the gospel's sake, that I may be partaker of it with you. Do you not know that those who run in a race all run, but one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you may obtain it. And everyone who competes for the prize is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a perishable crown, but we for an imperishable crown. Therefore I run thus, not with uncertainty. Thus I fight, not as one who beats the air, but I discipline my body and bring it into subjugation, lest when I have preached to others, I myself should become disqualified. The grace of the Father, God the Father, be with you all. Amen.
Yeah.
based on the blessings through this man. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to the pilgrims of the dispersion in Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia, elect according to the foreknowledge of God the Father, the sanctification of the Spirit, for obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace be multiplied. Blessed be the God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy he has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that does not fade away, reserved in heaven for you. You are kept by the power of God, through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials, that the genuineness of your faith, being much more precious than gold, that perishes through it is tested by fire, may be found to praise, honor, and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen you love, though now you see, you do not see him, yet believing you rejoice with joy, inexpressible and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, the salvation of your souls. Of this salvation the prophets have inquired and searched carefully, who prophesied of the grace that will come to you, searching what or what manner of time the Spirit of Christ who was in them was indicating when he testified beforehand the sufferings of Christ and the glory and the glories that would follow. To them it was revealed that, not to themselves but to us, they are ministering the things which now have been reported to you, to those who have preached the gospel to you, by the Holy Spirit sent from heaven, things which angels desire spoken to. Do not let the world be things of the world, the world pass away against us. He is the Lord God of us.
Increasingly added to the Lord multitudes of both men and women,
so that they brought the sick out into the streets and laid them on beds and couches, that at least the shadow of Peter passing by might fall on some of them. Also, a multitude gathered from the surrounding cities to Jerusalem, bringing sick people and those who were tormented by unclean spirits, and they were all healed. Then the high priest rose up and all those who were with him, which is the sect of the Sadducees, and they were filled with indignation, and laid their hands on the apostles and put them in the common prison. But at night an angel of the Lord opened the prison doors and brought them out and said, "Go, stand in the temple and speak to the people all the words of this life." And when they heard that, they entered the temple early in the morning and taught. But the high priest and those with him came and called the council together with all the elders of the children of Israel and sent to the prison to have them brought. The word of the Lord shall grow, multiply, be mighty, and be confirmed in the Holy Church of God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, who God, amen. Today is the third day of the blessed month of Abib. May God start it in good with me and renewed for us for many years and peaceful times. While our sins and iniquities are forgiven through the tender mercies of our merciful Lord. Amen.
On this day of the year 160 of the martyrs, 444 AD, the Holy Father, the pillar of faith, and the lamp of the Orthodox Church, Pope Carolus Caesar the First, 24th Patriarch of the See of St. Mark, departed. The saint was born in a village called Mahalikiborg to a deeply rooted family in the faith. He was discipled in his youth at the hand of his uncle Pope Theophilus, 23rd Patriarch. He loved reading the Holy Scriptures, the biographies of the Holy Fathers, and was interested in memorizing the church hymns and the praises. Then he studied in the Theological School of Alexandria, theology, philosophy, and many other subjects which he excelled in them. Saint Cyril went to the wilderness of Shehid and became a monk and a disciple to the Holy Father Abba Serapion for a period of 5 years. He grew in virtue, spiritual insight, worship, and asceticism. His uncle called him back and ordained him a priest in Alexandria, where he served with zeal. He attracted many by his godliness, purity, and was loved by everyone. After the departure of his uncle Pope Theophilus, the bishops and the archons and lay leaders chose him patriarch. He was consecrated on the 20th day of year 128 of the martyrs, 412 AD. The church was illuminated with his knowledge, and he gave a special attention to shepherding his flock and teaching them. He also resisted heresies and paganism. He refused the 10 essays of the Emperor Julian, the infidel, and he also revoked the judgment issued by his uncle against Saint John Chrysostom and added his name to the commemoration of the saints. When the heresy of Nestorius, Patriarch of Constantinople, emerged, he resisted it. At the time of the Feast of Resurrection, he sent a paschal letter to all the churches of the universe explaining the hypostatic union of the divinity with the humanity, as the union of the fire with the iron. When you hammer the iron, the hammering comes upon the iron, not the fire, even though the fire is united with the iron without mingling, without confusion, and without alteration. The fire keeps its fiery nature, and the iron keeps its nature. In regard of the title Theotokos, he said, "Any mother only gives a body to her son, yet she is considered a mother to the whole human being. Also, the Virgin Seminary is truth, she is the mother of God. For inside her womb grew the holy body, and thus the Savior took a made one with his divinity without mingling, without confusion, and without alteration. Therefore, she is totally a mother to her son, God the world." Pope Cyril sent another letter to Nestor explaining and then the Orthodox doctrine, and urged him to return to his senses. However, Nestor did not respond to his letter. Again, Carolus sent him another letter clarifying to him the danger of his belief. He also sent him a delegation to debate with Nestor his belief, but he refused to meet them. Pope Carolus convened a council of bishops of the See of St. Mark to discuss this heresy. The council judged Messer of being heretic and put down the introduction to the creed. He sent the decree of the Holy Council to the churches of the universe, among them was Constantinople. Nestor sent to Celestine, Pope of Rome, trying to attract him to his side. Meanwhile, Pope Rollo sent a letter to the Pope of Rome explaining to him his view about the controversy. Pope of Rome convened a council which excommunicated Nestor. He replied to the letter of Quirinus with a letter delegated in it. Pope Quirinus to deal with the situation as he saw fit for his confidence of the wisdom and knowledge of Pope of Alexandria. St. Quirinus convened a second council in Alexandria and decided to confirm the decisions of the previous council and demanded Nestor to sign on the council's decisions. However, Nestor refused to sign. Emperor Theodosius intervened and called for a universal council to convene at Ephesus, but Nestor also refused to attend the council. The council was started by reading the Creed of Faith of Nicaea and Constantinople, the letters of Pope Quirinus to Nestor, and his replies. The council judged Nestorius to be heretic, excommunicated, deposed him from his clerical office, and stripped him from the priesthood. Pope Quirinus suffered many difficulties because of his decision from John, Patriarch of Antioch, and some of the bishops of the East who took Nestor's side. However, shortly after they came back and agreed with the council's decision, the emperor exiled Nestor to Apnim in Upper Egypt in year 435 AD. From the monumental works of Pope Quirinus was his commentary on many of the holy books. He also made some additions to the Liturgy of St. Mark the Apostle, which is now known by the Liturgy of St. Cyril. He also composed some hymns about the Virgin St. Mary the Theotokos. When he finished his good endeavor, departed in peace after sitting on the throne of St. Mark 31 years, 8 months, and 10 days. The blessing of his prayer be with us all. Amen. On this day also of the year 148 of the Martyrs, 432 AD, Pope Celestine, Bishop of Rome, departed. This saint was a disciple of Saint Boniface, Bishop of Rome, who commanded at the time of his departure that Father Celestine would succeed him. He cautioned Celestine, saying, "Take heed, O my son, for there would be ravening wolves in the city of Rome." This father was a righteous and well-learned monk. After the departure of his teacher, they ordained him for the Roman See in the year 422 AD. During the reign of Emperor Honorius, this father faced many difficulties that forced him to go to one of the monasteries nearby Pentapolis, five cities, where he dwelt for a period of time, and God wrought many signs and miracles by his hands. Then the angel Raphael appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Rise up and go to Antioch to its saintly patriarch and abide with him, for the emperor had decided to kill you upon his return from war." He went to Antioch and dwelt in one of its monasteries. The saints Ignatius and Boniface, along with a third venerable person, appeared later on to the emperor in a dream and said to him, "Why have you left the city of the saints without a bishop? Behold, God will remove your soul from you, and you shall die by the hands of your enemies." The emperor asked, What shall I do? They replied, "Send and bring our son, the Bishop Celestine, with honor, and restore him to his throne." The emperor wrote to the Patriarch of Antioch, asking the whereabouts of Celestine, to return him to his throne with great honor. When the studious blasphemed, Celestine was unable to attend the Council of Ephesus in the year 431 AD. He sent two priests with a letter excommunicating him in it. When the Lord willed to repose him from the toil of his work, St. Boniface, his predecessor, and St. Athanasius the Apostolic, appeared to him and told him, "Rise, confirm your people in the faith, because you are coming to us, for the Lord Christ is calling you. When he woke up, he commanded his people, saying, take heed to yourselves, for behold, ravening wolf shall come into the city. I am leaving, for the saints are calling for me. When he said that, departed in peace. The blessing of his prayer be with us all, and glory be to our God forever and ever.
Assembly of the saints. be helped and reverenced by all those around him. Alleluia. Let them exalt him in the church of his people and praise him in the seat of the elders, for he has made the family like a flock of sheep. The upright shall see and rejoice. The Lord has sworn and will have no regrets. You are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. The Lord is at your right hand, our saintly Father, the Patriarch of Abba, Tawadros, and our Father, the Bishop of Abba, Youssef. May the Lord keep your lives.
After these things, the Lord appointed 70 others also, and sent them two by two before his face into every city and place where he himself was about to go. Then he said to them, "The harvest is truly great, but the laborers are few. Therefore pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Go your way. Behold, I send you out as lambs among wolves. Carry neither money bag, sack, nor sandals, and greet no one along the road. But whatever house you enter, first say peace to this house. And if a son of peace is there, your peace will rest on it. If not, it will return to you, and remain in the same house, eating and drinking such things as they give. For the laborer is worthy of his wages. Do not go from house to house. Whatever city you enter and they receive you, eat such things as are set before you, and heal the sick who are there, and say to them, the kingdom of God has come near to you. But whatever city you enter, and they do not receive you, go out into its streets and say, the very dust of your city, which clings to us, we wipe off against you. Nevertheless, know this, that the kingdom of God has come near you, but I say to you that it will be more tolerable in that day for Sodom than for that city. Woe to you, Chorazin, woe to you, Bethsaida, for if the mighty works which were done in you had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would have repented a great while ago, sitting in sackcloth and ashes. But it will be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon at the judgment than for you, and you, Capernaum, who are exalted to heaven, will be thrust down to Hades. He who hears you hears me, he who rejects you rejects me, and he who rejects me rejects him who sent me. Then the 70 returned with joy, saying, Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your name. And he said to them, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Behold, I give you the authority to trample on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. to serve. The Lord is the one who qualifies, and the Lord is the one who equips the people to serve. So when we ask God, and God actually sent the servants, these servants actually will help the service to prosper and grow. Because sometimes we have servants who are obstacles to the growth of the service. And this because we did not ask God. Maybe we chose them based on loyalty, based on friendship, based on their reputation among the community, etc. But if we ask God and actually insisted that no one will serve unless he is appointed by God through the life of prayer, then we'll have faithful and wise servant. In Matthew chapter 10, before the Lord sends the 12, we read that he spent the whole night in prayer. The whole night he spent in prayer so that those servants will be appointed by God. But here there is another question. The Lord said the harvest is truly great and the laborers are few. In spite of this, the Lord sent them two by two. If he sent the 70 two by two, then he sent them to 35 places. But if he sent them individually, he will send them into 70 places. We wonder why the Lord sent them two by two, although he said the harvest truly is great. Maybe it's wise to send them one by one. But when he sent them two by two to support one another, as we read in the scripture, two are better than one. And there are many challenges in the ministry. So when two are serving together, they can support one another. Also, when two work together and serve together, it needs humbleness so that they can be able to serve together. Because each one has his own opinion, has his own vision, has his own school in service. But when two together, they need to be humble in order to be able to work together in harmony. That's why the Lord actually sent them two by two. After this, the Lord told them, "Behold, I send you as lambs among wolves." The Lord did not actually make the service to sound very easy and no challenges in it and no problems in it. But he told them, "Behold, I send you out as lambs among wolves." What do we expect if a lamb goes among wolves? We expect to be devoured by the wolf. And this implies that when you are going to serve the Lord, don't expect an easy service. There are challenges, and these challenges may end in martyrdom and shedding the blood, as happened to most of the apostles. Maybe in the 12, the only one who was not martyred was St. John, but all of them were martyred. But I like what St. Ignatius said about this verse. St. Ignatius said, God sent us as lambs among wolves, so that the wolves devour us. And then, when they devour us, the wolves themselves will turn into lambs. And we can see this in the book of Acts, how St. Stephen was a lamb among wolves, those who stoned him to death. And one of them was St. Paul before his conversion, who actually approved the stoning of St. Stephen. But this image of St. Stephen being stoned and praying to God, asking God not to hold them accountable or don't charge them with this sin, this image was in St. Paul, in St. Paul's mind. And this was one of the goads that the Lord used to pierce the heart of St. Paul. And St. Paul, who was a wolf, devoured St. Stephen. Now he became a lamb like St. Stephen, and he was martyred for the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Behold, I send you as lambs among wolves. Then the following instruction was to trust the Lord. Don't trust anything else. Sometimes people, when they start ministry, maybe one of the first questions they ask, what is the budget for this ministry? And if the budget is zero, then they will say, how can I serve? But actually, the budget for the ministry of the apostles was actually zero, nothing. And the Lord told them, carry neither money bag, sack, nor sandals. So there was no budget. And this was a lesson to trust God, to put all their trust in God, in the ministry. And God will provide. When they returned, the Lord asked them a question. When I sent you, did you need anything? And the answer was no. God provided to them in a miraculous way. And some fathers actually reflected on carrying neither money bag, sack, nor sandals. So, in the story of St. Mark, you know in the story when he went to Egypt and his sandal was torn. If St. Mark had another sandal, then he would actually throw away the torn one and use the other one. But St. Mark, because he obeyed the Lord Jesus Christ, and they did not have another sandal with him. So start looking for someone to fix his sandal, to repair the sandal for him. And he met Inyanus. And this meeting with Inyanus was the spark that started the ministry in Egypt. Inyanus became later on the second Pope of Alexandria, and his house became the first church in Alexandria. So here we can see the fruit of obedience. He obeyed God and did not carry another sandal with him. And because of his obedience, this actually helped the ministry. He met the right person who became the successor of St. Mark, and his house became the first church in Alexandria. Then the Lord told them, and lead no one along to the road. The message here, don't let anything to distract you from your goal. Many times we are distracted from our ministry. God called us to serve Him and to call the people to reconcile with God. This is actually the focus of the ministry. As St. Paul said, we are the ambassadors of Christ. We call you to be reconciled with God. And our ministry is a ministry of reconciliation, to reconcile the people with God. That's why the ordination of the priest and the ordination of the deacons are done after the reconciliation prayer, to indicate that the goal of the ministry is to reconcile people with God. Many times we are distracted from this goal with so many activities that has nothing to do with the goal. And we keep ourselves busy and distracted without focusing on the goal of the ministry, which is the salvation of everyone and the reconciliation with God. That's why the Lord told them, greet no one along the road. Then the Lord told them, but whatever house you enter, first say, peace to this house. And the Lord here wants to tell them, your ministry is ministry of peace. Your message is message of peace. The servant of the Lord should be peacemaker and should grant everyone the message of peace from the Lord. That's why in the Divine Liturgy, several times, Abuna says, Irini Pasi, which means peace to all. Again, this work as a reminder to us that our ministry is ministry of peace. Some servants, when actually they start serving, they cause problem and they cause trouble and they cause division and they cause confusion among the people. And instead of the people come to the church, or instead of the students come to Sunday school classes and live with peace in their heart, instead of coming tired and carrying burdens, and then they leave from the church with peace in their heart, sometimes the opposite may happen. Because of the way the servant conducts himself. That's why the Lord said, when you enter any house, say to this house, peace be with you. But the question here, what if the people in the house are not peaceful? They are troublemakers. How should I handle this situation? The Lord told us, it's not your business. This is my actual responsibility. Go and give the message of peace. And if a son of peace is there, your peace will rest on it. If not, if there is no son of peace in this house, then your peace will return to you. But this is my responsibility. You go without examining who deserves the peace and who does not, go and give the message of peace to everyone. Those who are children of peace will receive it. Those who are not, then the peace will return back to you. Also, the Lord gave them another message, very important for the servant, which is to be content. He told them, the laborer is worthy of his wages. Do not go from house to house, but remain in the same house, eating and drinking such things as they get. So here the message is the message of contentment. Whatever they provide to you, take it and be thankful to the Lord. Don't move from house to house looking for a better house, a better host that you can accommodate you better than the previous house. Be content. And St. Paul in Philippians chapter 4, he spoke about how he trained himself to be content in any situation he goes through. He says, I learned how to be content. I learned how to be hungry and how to be full. I learned how to be abased and how to abound. Then he said, I did all of this. I can do all things in Jesus Christ who strengthens me. Contentment is a very important also virtue in ministry. Because people who are not content, they will be looking for a better Sunday school class, a better church, and they will move from place to place in order to satisfy their hunger to a better place for themselves. And if they are not content, they will never find this better place, because when they go to another place, they will look to a better place, and so on. But the Lord here told them, be content. When the Lord, the Holy Spirit said, sent Barnabas and Paul to this ministry, they did not say no, but wanted to go to this country instead of this country. They were content. So it is a ministry of contentment. There are many points, but the last point I will mention here, when the Lord told them, say to the people, the kingdom of God has come near to you. So again, the message of repentance. The kingdom of God has come near to you. Either to accept this kingdom by life of repentance, and then you will have heavenly inheritance, or to reject this kingdom. And if you reject this kingdom, then the person will remain in the kingdom of darkness, kingdom of Satan. So it is the choice of everyone to choose either the kingdom of God or the kingdom of darkness and death. Those who choose the kingdom of God by believing in the Lord Jesus Christ and living the life of repentance, then they will inherit the heavenly inheritance. Those who reject the kingdom of God, and rather they stay in the kingdom of darkness and kingdom of death, they choose for themselves eternal condemnation. The Lord actually, over the ages, from actually Old Testament until now, is sending all the time prophets, apostles, clergy, servants, in order to serve us, in order to guide us to the way of salvation. And the message is a message of peace. message of repentance, message of healing. That is the message that the Lord is sending us. It is up to us whether to accept it or to reject it. If we accept it, we'll be among the children of God. If we reject it, these people will be in the kingdom of Satan. It is our choice how to respond to the commission of the servant, how to respond to the message that the Lord is sending us through his servants. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.
Blessed are they in truth.
Souls
preserved by your Holy Spirit, and let not the death of sins have dominion over us, we your servants, nor over all your people.
Lord, have mercy.
Archbishop of the great city of Alexandria, and his brother, the Apostolic Liturgy, the Patriarch of Antioch, Mark Nassus of Prime, and his partner, the Apostolic Liturgy, our father, the Bishop, Abba Youssef, and four Orthodox bishops.
Lord, have mercy.
If they are secure for us from years and peaceful times, fulfilling that holy high priesthood, with which I entrusted them for yourself, a furniture, one and blessed will, rightly handling the word of truth, purity, confusion, and righteousness, and all Orthodox bishops, deacons, priests, and deacons, and all the fullness of the one, all your holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Grant them and us peace and sit in every place, the prayer with the upper heart they have,
on behalf of all your people.
As well as ours on their behalf, receive them upon your holy Russian altar in heaven as a sweet savor of incense. All their enemies, visible, invisible, trampling and relief under their feet speedily. As for them, keep them in peace and righteousness in your holy
the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, our assemblies, bless them.
Pray for this holy church and for our assemblies.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant that they may be to us without obstacle or hindrance, that we hold them according to your holy and blessed will, houses of prayers, houses of purity, houses of blessings. Grant them to us, O Lord, and to your servants, who will come after us forever. The worship of idols, utterly uprooted from the world, Satan and all his evil powers, trample and humiliate them under our feet speedily, the offenses and their instigators abolished. Let the dissensions of corrupt heresies cease, the enemies of your holy church, O Lord, as at all times some also humiliate, strip their vanity, show them their weaknesses speedily, bring to naught their envies, their entering, their madness, and their wickedness, and their slanders which they commit against us, O Lord, bring them all to no avail, disperse their counsel, O God, who disperses the counsel of Ahithophel.
Lord, have mercy.
Arise, O Lord, the God, let all your enemies be scattered, and let all who greet your holy name flee before your face. But let your people be in blessing, thousands of thousands, and ten thousand times ten thousand, doing your will.
Sofia teu proscomen, crea lai son, quin omit mi.
Uli, ili, imaga, God the Father, the Mother, the Creator, creator of heaven and earth, and all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only God, Son of God, begotten of the Father, of all ages, alive, of life, true God, begotten, not created, of one essence of the Father, by whom all things are made, but who for
Christ, Lamb for our salvation, came down from heaven, was incarnated of the Holy Spirit, the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified for us on Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried. On the third day, he rose from the dead, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into the heavens. He sits at the right hand of his Father, and he is coming again in glory to judge the living and the dead. Who can and shall I find? Yes, believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, which proceeds from the Father, with the Father and the Son, who is and glorified, who spoke by the prophets, and one holy Catholic, Father, Church, we confess from baptism for the remission of sins.
We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
I have sinned, forgive me. And to his good glory, honor and adoration from all. God's angel that is his army. Establish grace of ministry to it, and pour out your gifts on your servants, sanctifying this your servant also, and appoint him as a leader, and make him worthy with all wisdom and understanding to perform the meditation and reading of divine words, and fill him with your gifts, while he is preserved in blameless conduct by the mercies of your only begotten Son, through whom and with whom glory, honor, and dominion are due to you, with your good life-giving and consubstantial with Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the age of ages. Amen.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
O great and loving God, in whose hands all things are held, and by whose commands all things are controlled, who are near to all and stand by all, look upon this your servant, who is presented by us to be a proclaimer of your holy words of the Old and New Testament, that he may expound to the people your holy words and your right precepts, and proclaim your divine and salutary doctrines, which you have appointed for the help and salvation of our souls. O God, instruct him in your commandments, and make him understand your justifications, and illumine the eyes of his mind to the light of the knowledge of your commandments, and grant to him that with purity of heart and unfeigned faith, he may perform the meditations and readings for the uplifting of those who hear, to the praise and glory of your kingdom, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and the age of the ages. Amen.
Approval in the proper time of order in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
the Holy Ghost, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Yea, Lord, who art Jesus Christ, the Son of God, hear us and have mercy upon us. Offer, offer, offer in order, stand with trembling, look toward the east, let us
Amen.
when we disobeyed your commandment by the deceit of this weapon, we fell from eternal life and were exiled from the paradise of joy. You have not abandoned us to thee, but have always visited us through your holy prophets, and in the last days you manifested yourself to us while sitting in darkness and the shadow of death. Through your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who of the Holy Spirit and of the Holy Virgin Mary.
Amen. Bishops, and Holy Apostles say, take it of it, all of you, for this is my body, which is broken for you and for many, to be given for the remission of sins. This do in remembrance of me.
This is true. Amen.
Likewise also the cup after supper, he mixed it of wine and water, and when he had given thanks,
Church. Saints of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church of God.
Lord, have mercy.
This which have acquired to yourself with the precious blood of your Christ, keep here in peace with all of the peace of war in here. For most remember, O Lord, our peace and our Father, Archbishop, our Bishop of our Daughters the Second, and his Bishop brothers, the Bishop of Antichrist, the Second, and his brothers, our Son, Bishop, our brother, Bishop Abba,
and his brother in the Apostolic Liturgy, the Patriarch of Antioch, Maronite Youssef, and his partner in the Apostolic Liturgy, our father, the Bishop Abba Youssef, and for our Orthodox bishops.
Lord, have mercy.
And those who are dead is the word of Jewish
Amen. Lord,
Christ, your loving Son, and the Holy Spirit, peace be with all.
You glorify you, and we give thanks to your own account.
purify our hearts, our souls, bodies, and spirits, so that with a pure heart, we may with boldness without fear to cry out to your Holy Father, who is in the heavens, and say, Our Father. Remember, Lord, our assembly in the land.
Say amen with your spirit in the field of the Tassate.
Amen, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
The Holy Spirit, the Holy Christ, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Sanctification is by the Holy Spirit. Amen.
What is your Holy Father?
Salvation of sins and eternal life to those who partake of him.
Lord have mercy.